I get a lot of questions about Lightroom versus Capture One with regard to image quality. If you're new to Fujifilm and are just starting to get into RAW files, you need to pay attention to this video. Well, after the intro, of course. Hi everyone and welcome to Pal to Tech. Unlike a JPEG file, a RAW file contains no image in it whatsoever. Think of a RAW file as a series of binary data, basically ones and zeros, that's a set of instructions as to how you've captured the exposure and the scene. And because of this, a RAW file that you shoot will look different when you pull it up in each different photo editing application. The second factor are the settings you make in that software, right? You can adjust the sharpening, color highlights, contrast, you know, that kind of thing. Just about every camera on Earth uses a Bayer sensor that looks like this and has a 2x2 pattern of pixels. However, Fujifilm uses a special X-Trans sensor that instead uses a 6x6 configuration. And because of this, the manner in which the RAW editing software, such as Lightroom or Capture One, they must take that sensor type into account accordingly. I have the latest versions of both Lightroom and Capture One. Let me show you now what happens when you open exactly the same RAW file in each software application with the same default settings. Nothing's changed. The latest version. Let's open up an image right now and see kind of what's going on here. I don't know if you can see this or not, but there are wormy artifacts in this image right on the skin. You can see it here, you can see it here, you can see it here. Let's take a look at another example of a RAW file in Lightroom under the default settings. As you can see, there's these artifacts right here. The reason you're getting these wormy artifacts is because Lightroom can't quite handle the X-Trans sensor, so what it's doing is it's almost over sharpening it. If you look at the default sharpening settings in Lightroom, you'll see this. Now, if you turn down the sharpening, you'll get rid of the worms, right? There it goes, see? Now, if you turn down the sharpening, you should reduce the worms. Check it out. I'm now turning down the sharpening and the worms are going away. Of course, this picture is getting softer, so it's a balance you have to strike. You know, people have different ways of dealing with this. Some people will turn the sharpening here, then they'll crank up the detail all the way to 100, and then they'll kind of move the sharpening back down. They'll work with those sliders to try and fix this problem, but it is an issue that results from the fact that Lightroom doesn't process the X-Trans sensor RAW files in the way that they should. Let's take a look at the same RAW file now in Capture One. Again, default settings, nothing's been changed. Okay, there's no doubt about it at all. The RAW file on the left is Capture One, the RAW file on the right is Lightroom. And obviously, I could go into the sharpening, bring down the sharpening, bring perhaps up the detail a little bit, bring down the radius, and kind of monkey and play around with these settings. But at the end of the day, when you open up a RAW file in Lightroom and in Capture One, you wind up having to do less work initially in Capture One because it's more ready to go, so to speak. You don't have to fiddle with the details and the radius and the sharpening sliders as you do in Lightroom. Now, Adobe, for what it's worth, decided to come up with a solution to this, and they called it Enhanced Details. Let me show you what that means. You right-click a picture, you select Enhanced Details, and you gotta wait for this box to come up. Tick tock, tick tock, in my workflow. I'm waiting. There, it finally comes up. Okay, now, here's problem number one. Estimated time, 10 seconds. So 10 seconds each, multiply that times, you know, 500 RAW files or 1,000 from a major photo shoot you do. That's crazy to spend that much time. So you obviously would need to be selective of each one that you would want. So if you click on Enhance, now you wait. Let me speed this up for you. Okay, so what happened here? Lightroom created a brand new file, a DNG file. So now you have two files of the same image, a RAW and a DNG. Let's look at the DNG now. The picture on the left is enhanced. You can see it says it right here. The one on the right is the regular Fujifilm RAW file. All right, so as you can see, there's worming right here that's less. And as you kind of look down and look around over here, it's a little bit better, but it's not a lot better. Now, here's the problem with it, okay? I don't think a lot of people talk about this problem. Look at the file size. It's 117 megs for the one file, okay? That is double what the raw file is. So every single time you use enhanced details on every single file, you are doubling the file size of your original raw file and creating another file. So you're getting two files now. One of them is double the first one. Multiply that out times lots and lots of pictures. So that's a problem. I don't think that enhanced details is really worth a whole lot. I made this video because I get a lot of questions about what's this whole raw file, Capture One, Lightroom thing. Well, that's what it's about. There is no easy answer. And if you would like me to do more tutorials on, say, round trip workflows in Lightroom, like using Iridiot Developer and going back into Lightroom, or using Photoshop and then going back into Lightroom and that sort of thing, I'm happy to do that. And as I start to become more familiar with Capture One, I am absolutely going to make Capture One tutorials. That is where I think I'm going to go and head down the road. Anyway, that wraps it up for this Fast Friday. I hope you have a great weekend. If you like this video, give it the like and subscribe, and I will see you again real soon. Take care.